This is Mission Control Houston. Good morning to you from the International Space Station Flight Control Room, and welcome to ISS Update. It is Monday, April 9th, 2012. The crew's got a very busy day today, working on a variety of different maintenance tasks and also quite a bit of onboard training and experiment work. Dan Burbank, who is the commander, started off his morning with some routine maintenance on the spacesuits that are on board inside the Quest airlock. Those have to be maintained periodically by scrubbing the coolant loops. You see the work there going on inside Quest. There is Burbank. He's also going to be unstowing some materials today for the combustion integrated rack. This is one of the onboard facilities that the crew performs different experiments on. It deals with exactly what it sounds like, different types of combustion elements. It has an optics bench inside, a combustion chamber, which you see is the large part there in the middle. It's got fuel and oxidizer controls and five different cameras, so the crew and the ground teams can watch what the crew does. It can also perform experiments in either high or low pressure, so they can simulate a vacuum or take it up to three times an atmosphere of what you would find here on Earth. Anton Shkaplerov also busy today taking some measurements inside the Zvezda service module. He's making sure that there are no contaminants or anything untoward there inside the Russian segment. This is typical that the crew does every few weeks or so. He's also working on what's called the Kulinovsky crystal experiment. It looks at how crystals form in space. It could lead to better designs for solar arrays on future spacecraft by improving the current that is distributed from those solar arrays into the spacecraft itself. Shkaplerov also working on stowing some items in the Progress 46, which is currently docked with the Piers docking compartment. That is one of the cargo crafts that visit the International Space Station. You see the Progress back there on the Russian segment. This is the current layout of the station with the Soyuz 28 or TMA-22 up there on top. That is the Poisk module that is on the space-facing side of the Russian segment. The Soyuz 29 or TMA-03M is down there on Rosvet, which is close to the Zarya module. And then the newly arrived ATV-3, the large European Space Agency cargo craft back there on the Zvezda service module as well. But that Progress 46 is getting close to its final few days on board the International Space Station. It is going to be undocked coming up on April 19th, so the crew is getting everything set for that. Anatoly Ivanishin also been working on some of the cargo stowage from that Progress this morning as well. He has also been working on what is called the Uragon Experiment. This started back on board the Mir space station, but basically it utilizes and takes advantage of the unique vantage point of the space station up close to 240 miles up in space, and uses the orbiting complex to take photos and videos of different types of natural and man-made phenomena down on the planet to help analyze and better predict certain types of disasters that happen here on Earth. Ivanishin, as well as Oleg Kononenko, also working on what's called the Toru, which is the telerobotically operated rendezvous system. This is a series of controls back in the Russian segment in the Zvezda service module that the crew mans and watches over should they ever have to take control of a rendezvous and approaching spacecraft. But this is all being done in advance of the Progress 46, which, as we mentioned, is going to back away from the station and undock on April 19th, so they're going to be checking out that Toru system today. Don Pettit, which you're hearing the voice of here just a few seconds ago, also working on quite a number of different science experiments on board. Namely, he is working on one called the burning and suppression of solids. This is an experiment that looks at different fuels and how the burn of those fuels takes place in space. Hopefully this will lead to better fire protection, detection, and suppression in space and also here on Earth. He and Kuipers are also starting about 2 weeks worth of training today. This is all coming up for the approaching date of the SpaceX launch, the SpaceX Dragon spacecraft getting ready to head up to the International Space Station. Both Pettit and Kuipers are going to be manning the station's robotic arm, which will be used once Dragon gets close to the station. At a distance of about 30 foot, that arm will be used to grapple onto Dragon and bring it in and berth it with the bottom side of the Harmony node. So today, Pettit and Kuipers are starting about 2 weeks worth of training, getting ready for all the different onboard activities that they will do as that mission draws near. They're also having a meeting today with flight controllers here in Houston to take a look at what's ahead for them over the next couple of weeks.